Hello, my name is Gustavo Galas from copahost.com web hosting. In this video, we're going to talk about HTML images, the image tag. The image tag is one of the most used ones in HTML. It's very easy and simple to use. Let's create the raw image tag. So there is the image tag and the src, the source attribute. In the source attribute, we really need to add the image location. This can be the link, an external link, or else the file name of the image. So we have the tag image with the source pointing to doc.jpg, which is a local file we have in the same directory as the web page. So let's see how it looks like. So we have here the image in their HTML page. So right now I'm going to show you how to place a title in the image using the title attribute. So we have the tag image, we have the attribute source with the image file name, and we have the title. The title will appear as you place the mouse over the image. It appears the title My Dog, which is the title we have just placed here. Now let's talk about the alt attribute, the alternative attribute. The alt attribute is used for some reason when the image is broken. Let's say we have an image that doesn't exist locally or that have moved the file. So instead of showing the image, the browser will show the alternative text, the content of the alt attribute. So for instance, we are placing the text dog image missing inside the alt attribute. Let's save here and reload. So as we place the mouse over the image, nothing happens. We can see the old title called My Dog, which is the content of this attribute here. So let's change the file name to something that we know that doesn't exist to see how it behaves. Instead of dog.jpg, we are going to place dog222. .jpg, which is a name we know that doesn't exist here locally. Let's reload the page. So now we can't see the image, but we have the alternative text here, dog image missing, which is the content of the alt attribute. Remember that the alt attribute is very important for Google, for your SEO of your web page. Google loves it. It's important to say to customers what's inside the image if we get broken for some reason. Now we are heading back to the old file name, the doc.jpg, which is a file name we know that exists locally. Now we're going to reload the page. Let's see the dog again. Now I'm going to show you how to style this image, how to change the size. So we have added the style attribute here. To change the width and the height of the image, we can simply do like this. We have just placed the style attribute and inside it width of 500 pixels. So the image is way bigger than it was in the past. For instance, let's change this to 50 only, 50 pixels. And let's reload the page. So now the image is very small, it's very tiny. Just like the width attribute, we can just set the height attribute. We can set both width and height. If you only set one of them, or width or height, it will keep the proportion of the image so that it just doesn't get messy. But if you specify both of them, let's see how it looks like. I have just placed width of 500 and height of only 50 pixels. So the image will be messy, but this is a possibility. Now if you do the opposite, let's set the height of 600 and the width of only 50. Let's reload. The image will be just tiny. But let's go back to the default with nothing set in the style attribute. Now we have the dog image as its default. Now we're going to show you how to use a link in the image. So we have here the image tag. All we need to do is place the anchor link, the A link. So we have the image tag here. Then we have outside the image tag, the A tag. The A tag have its href pointing to copperhost.com, an external web page. So let's save and let's reload here. So as we place the mouse over the image, we have the finger pointer. And as we click the image, we're going to be redirected to the other page desired. Let's just come back here. So in this first sample, we have just opened the image called dog.jpg, which is located in the same folder as the HTML file. For instance, this is our HTML file called page.htm, and this is dog.jpg, which is our image. We can just point to a different image in a different folder this way. We have the folder named folder, and we have a different image here called image.png. So we're going to place the folder name bar image.png. We're going to save it and reload. Now we have the different image inside the other folder. So let's just get back to the old image, the dog image. Let's save it. Okay, so now we're going to show you how to float, how to organize the image together with text in your web page. Let's make the paragraph tag. Okay. Now we're going to add some text here. So we have the image tag inside the paragraph tag. We have another video where we explain more about the paragraph tag. So let's see how it looks like by default. So by default, we have the image here with the text coming right after the image here. So inside the style attribute, we can use the float attribute. If you use float left, let's see how it behaves. So float left tells the image to be positioned right to the left and leave all the remaining text to the right. We have the text here on the right side and the image floating positioned to the left. If we do float right, let's see how it looks like. Now the image is positioned to the right and all the remaining text to the left. Remember that this behavior only works inside paragraphs. So that's it. This is the behavior of the HTML image tag. Thanks for watching.